And the topic for today's discussion, the topic for today's Power Talk is, are women safe in India? See, we saw this horrific crime happen in Kolkata, the Kolkata rape. Initially, India was talking about, are women safe in hospitals? Are female doctors, female medical students safe in hospitals? That's what India was talking about initially. But later on, these protests escalated and they became nationwide. And now India is talking about, are women safe in India? And to discuss this matter further, in further detail, as promised, joining us today at CVR English Newsroom live once again, all the way from Switzerland, is former Executive Director of Sports Authority of India and Arjuna Awardee, Rachna Govilji. She has served as the chairperson of Internal Committee of Sexual Harassment of Women at Workplace in the Sports Authority of India, and she has vast experience of working for promotion of sports in remote and tribal areas of India. Ma'am, namaskar. Aapka ek baar fir se CVR Newsroom mein swagat hai. Can you hear us now, ma'am?
Yes.
Just a bit of context before I get into this conversation with ma'am. Just a bit of context for all our viewers. Rachna Govilji, a highly proactive social activist for women's rights, she has significantly contributed in developing a safe Indian society for women by and large. She won the Arjuna Award, an award attached with the highest prestige for any sports person in the country, in the year 2000. She has also been conferred with the prestigious Yash Bharati and the Lakshmi Bai Bravery Awards by the government of Uttar Pradesh in 2016, and not just that, the list is not done yet. Ma'am has also won the Best Woman Shooter Award in the Northern India Shooting Championship in 1998. Ma'am, we welcome you. We are indeed honored to have you with us at CVR English Newsroom. Yahan par aapka bahut bahut swagat hai, ma'am. Ek baar fir se.
Dhanyawad.
Ma'am, jumping right into the second question, starting from where we left off, bringing me to the next question. These nationwide protests which have been going on, ma'am, they may have started due to the rape murder incident at a hospital in Kolkata. But now the national question is, are women safe anywhere at work? Mahilaye kahin par bhi surakshit hain kya? And I'm speaking particularly in the context of our country, India. Your thoughts on this matter, ma'am?
It's not only in India. I think all over the world, the women are not safe. In fact, the report given by the UN Office on Drug and Crime, it says that 47,000 women were killed by their intimate friends, male friends, or by the family members in the year 2020. So, if you see that there was a killing of a female every 13 minutes, which is like too much. And of course, as far as Asian region is concerned, which is ranked the top most, and then comes Africa. But in Europe, the situation is better. And in fact, they have seen an improvement. They have seen a decrease in crime rate to the extent Eastern Europe, which countries like Poland and Belarus and Slovakia, there it has gone down to even 47%, whereas in Western Europe it is about 13% or so. So overall the situation is not very good, but then yes, it depends from country to country. Unfortunately, in our country it is not a good situation. If you remember, there was of course, I'll talk to you about 40 years back, there was a nurse who was, she went to the washroom and she was raped there, and then she went into coma to defend herself. She got injuries, and then when she was, nobody noticed, and it was only in the morning when people noticed, and then she was into a very bad situation for many years, and the nurses were looking after that nurse. But the situation has not improved. I think even you see the case of Nirbhaya, how she was brutally killed. It shakes me. And then that was in 2012. Again in 2017, there was a serious case where the woman was raped and then hanged. And then in 2019, I think again, which they start terming it as Nirbhaya 3. And the woman was again, in this case, she was raped and burnt alive. So the situation is quite bad. And I think we all need to look into it, and we all need to provide proper safe environment to a woman, especially at the working place. Because I have worked, and I have also seen that when you go to your office, you feel that is another home for you. No matter, even if you are alone, you feel as if you are safe. But then it is shocking that how this incident of a doctor took place, something somewhere where the female feels that she is safe, but actually she is not. So the organizations will have to take very strict measures to see, even, you know, measures like installing cameras, monitoring them, and patrolling of that particular area, proper sanitization of certain areas when they know that this place is not going to be in use for the day, then proper sanitization should be done. All these measures will have to be taken to make women safe.
I totally understand and totally agree with you, ma'am. Like you said, over the course of time, even in the last 20 years, we have been witnessing and we have been listening about so many crimes happening against women.
Can you please repeat again? There is some disturbance.
I completely agree with you, ma'am. Over this period of time that has passed, we have witnessed consistent crime against women. Cut to today, even in the present scenario, the Kolkata rape murder case, again we are witnessing a horrific crime happening against a woman. Again we are witnessing this public outrage. Now ma'am, you come from a pure sports background. I would like to ask you my next question. You are particularly known, you have that image in the society of upholding and ensuring women's safety, empowerment and their well-being at work. And I agree with you when you say that when we go to our office is like our extended family. Hum jab office jaate hain to hame lagta hai ki hum ek extended family mein aa gaye. You come from a sports background, you are such a prominent sports person from our country. To khel jagat ki duniya mein महिला खेल जगत की दुनिया में ये जो महिला सशक्तिकरण है, अगर इसकी बात करी जाए, यू बीइंग द फॉर्मर एग्जीक्यूटिव डायरेक्टर ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया एंड द रेसिपिएंट ऑफ द मोस्ट प्रेस्टिजियस अर्जुना अवार्ड, यू हैव विटनेस्ड द स्पोर्ट्स सोशल फैब्रिक ऑफ इंडिया. इट हैज ग्रोन एंड इवॉल्व्ड ओवर द इयर्स एंड यू हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड इट क्लोजली बोथ द अर्बन एंड द रूरल ऑन अ डे टू डे बेसिस. My question is very direct. When it comes to sports, do women, and by women I mean female athletes, do they also face sexual harassment, ma'am?
You know, comparatively, I feel that in sports, we don't come across, we do come across where there may be some talk which is not liked by the girl. Those type of incidences we do come across, but not too much. And in sports, one good thing is there that the girl does become bold. But if you see all over the world, again I say that you must have heard the case of where even Simone Biles came up, and this this Dr. Larry, he molested, I think, more than 265
girls.
Yes,
the world knows about that incident. Yes.
Yeah. So there are instances, and all over the world, these things do happen. In fact, I was also studying, reading a case where these girls were basketball players. This is not a case in India, and these girls were basketball players, and they were being trained by a coach, where the coach was used to make the girls, if the girls don't play well, then he will make a particular girl sit on his lap. But he was a very good coach, And the sad part of it was that the girl said that once I make my career, I will never look back. So imagine, true, despite being a good coach, the girl never wanted to come back, even to look back at him. That much they hate the person.
Ma'am,
but then of course, as yeah,
ma'am, tell me. In the field of sports, talking about sports, you being a sportswoman, are we taking proactive measures to ensure, like you said, compared to the other industries, female athletes do not face as much of sexual harassment, but they might not face as much, but yet they do. So in order to ensure the female athletes' empowerment, are we doing something to safeguard them? Are we doing something to empower them so that they can safeguard themselves against this kind of predatory behavior, maybe from their coaches or somebody else in the industry? Are we doing something about it?
See, actually, if we talk about Sports Authority of India in particular, they have a very good system, right from not only surveillance, everything is under surveillance, there are proper cameras, but there are female coaches also. There is a full system involved in it. I mean, if I was just seeing, if you go to a hospital, you will not come across where it will be displayed that this is the sexual harassment committee and anybody facing problem can make it, and their phone numbers also displayed. I have not come across. But if you go to any of the offices of Sports Authority, everything is like displayed, and people know to whom to contact. And there are wardens looking after the children. So it's a very good system they have.
That is very nice to know, very reassuring to know, rather, that everything is so crystal clear and transparent in terms of communication when it comes to the Sports Authority of India, of which you have been the former executive director yourself. Ma'am, just a general question.
Other than that, I would like to add is that we conduct lot of awareness programs also, both for boys and girls.
Oh, lovely.
See, it's very important even to educate the coaches, the male athletes. It's not just important for education of female, but it's also important to educate our male athletes too, and also the coaches and the administrators. So this is a very ongoing process, and it goes on continuously.
Absolutely. It's not just about empowering the women, but it's also about educating and sensitizing the men. Ma'am, which brings me to my next question. Like, in a country like India, where we live, in general, just asking you in general, out of curiosity, do Indian women in general have the courage to say no when they actually mean no? Because it is so important to be courageous and bold these days. It is so important to be able to stand up, show up and speak up for oneself. Are the women in India bold enough, like you were bold enough to question the higher authorities about disparity in the award money between men and women after winning a major competition, despite possible repercussions, ma'am?
I think comparatively the women in sports are bold and they come forward, and at times it does happen, you know, a girl coming from remote areas, she may not be bold enough to express, but then since the whole system is involved in it, the girls are encouraged to speak out their problems or their complaints. Sometimes they may have a fear that they will be out of the team. They may have that fear.
That's
I agree,
a very legitimate fear.
But at the same time, yes, but at the same time, if the girls are encouraged to speak, and if they know very well that there is a system behind them, they will certainly speak out. I remember in my time, I wanted to ask that.
Yes.
In my time, that was my first national, and I was told to run in the senior junior category by the state association. But then my coach told that finally one day if you have to be successful, you will have to compete in senior level. So there's no point running in juniors, and you run in seniors, you lose the race, but I want to see how you perform. And so I ran in the seniors, although I lost, but After that, I was not liked by the Federation and I did suffer. But unfortunately, those days, there was no such system where a complaint could be made. There was no such thing like that. And so I fought out my issues. Of course, I didn't go back. And then in 81, I broke the national record also in 3000 meter. I didn't fall back. But then one has to be bold. And I think even the parents of the girls, they should come forward and they should always accept what the girl is telling. They should not say, "Arey, tumhe shak ho raha hoga. Arey, tum chup laga jati. You should not have given a reply." I think that is not right. The parents should support their girls and make them bold to express, even at the highest level, as you just reminded me about it. When I ran the Indira Marathon and I won the marathon, and the prize money that time, this was in 85, the prize money was 10,000 for men and 50,000 for women. So when the Honorable Prime Minister was giving the prizes, I spoke and I said that it is in the name of a lady, and whereas the prize money is less for us. So it was quite surprising for him, and then immediately action was taken and the prize money was made the same. But then although I was criticized by some people and they said, "Why did you speak out?" I said, "I must, and there is nothing wrong." So even if you are being criticized or whatever it is, I think it's very important that the girls should be bold, should take a step and speak out, because by keeping quiet, they are not going to get anything. By being threatened that you will be out of the team tomorrow, that person may threaten you for something else. True. So why to keep quiet at the first stage itself? It's always good to express.
Absolutely, ma'am, I agree with you. By staying quiet, we are enabling the perpetrator and we are normalizing this kind of behavior. And hats off to you that at the peak, at the pinnacle of your success, despite possible ramifications, you had the boldness to even question the Honorable Prime Minister. Ma'am, moving on to the next question, looking at the limited amount of time that we have. Speaking of countries with almost 0% crime rate against women, and also of the world's happiest countries, you have, for instance, connected with us all the way from such a happy country, that is Switzerland. What is the governance there like? And how does it lead to such a decrease in the crime rate over there? What is it in our governance structure that we might be lacking and those countries are not lacking?
Well, this situation in our country as well, and as far as Switzerland is concerned, is quite different. Here the population is too less, and from day one the child is brought up in a very different manner. Everybody speaks very softly, so the child also learns to speak very softly. And there is a very good law they have, that is called the Clare's Law. And in that, there is a policy under which the police can provide information to a lady if she wants to know the background of the person, even her ex-partner, if she wants to know the background, in the sense whether having a history of crime or not, or to the present partner, and it will all be kept confidential. So they don't hide facts, and it's quite open to everybody. They provide that support.
Which brings me to my last question, ma'am, for this power talk, a rather paradoxical question. Why Indian ancient culture has become so diluted? This is a culture where women were considered divine for centuries. What has led to such a massive devaluation, degradation and dilution of our rich ancient Indian culture, where women were worshipped, they were held in high reverence? How did we come to such a pass after all, where we are discussing such horrific crimes against women today?
Actually, as far as worshipping women deities are concerned, that is still being done. Even today we worship Saraswati, we worship
That's why the
Durga.
Paradox, ma'am.
We worship even today, and I think earlier also crime against a woman must have been taking place, but there was no such media or no such system where a woman can address. And the woman was, those days, if you see, the woman was not working. She was completely at the mercy of the man, and she was supposed to just do things inside the house, whereas the man had the liberty to go out and then and at the same time come home and dominate over her. But I think that though that time also things would have been wrong. I will not say that, but today I think the woman has got a chance to speak and express. People have become more aware, and so they are coming out and raising a voice also. So it's just a change in the system, but actually overall I think we need to be, and then we are competing also with the Western world. That is also one thing. I have seen, like, if a woman is wearing pant shirt, she's considered to be are badi smart samajhti hai apne aap ko, you know, those type of comments. And but if a woman is comfortable in pant shirt, there is nothing wrong. At the same time, I strongly believe that we must love our culture, we must respect our culture, and we should always be proud of our culture. In fact, I was just thinking about the word ma, which comes not just from the mouth, it comes from deep inside. Whereas when you say mom, it doesn't come so. And I have often heard, even in here, you know, saying mama. So when it comes from deep inside, I think we should be proud of calling our mothers as ma.
Ma. Yes. So it's, and here all in the matter. South, in Hyderabad, we say amma.
Amma. Yes. So it comes from inside. So we should feel proud of our culture.
That feels so good. It feels so good to end this power talk on such a happy, positive note with you. Rachna ma'am, it has always been a pleasure to meet you, to connect with you. And today I feel honored on behalf of CVR English to connect with you right here in Hyderabad in our newsroom. आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आज हमारे साथ स्विट्जरलैंड से जुड़ने के लिए.
थैंक यू
सो मच मैम. लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, दैट वॉज रचना गोविल जी शेयरिंग हर इनवैल्यूएबल एक्सपीरियंस एंड इनसाइट्स ऑन हाउ टू एंश्योर वुमेन सेफ्टी एट वर्क विद अस. एंड आवर मेन फोकस टुनाइट रिमेन्स द सेम, हाउ कैन वी स्टॉप दीज अटैक्स ऑन वुमेन इन द फर्स्ट प्लेस. द डॉक्टर्स ऑलरेडी हैव एन आइडिया. They've been demanding a Central Protection Act. It was first drafted in 2019. It mandates strict punishment for assaulting doctors, up to 10 years in jail, plus up to 10 lakh rupees fine. The idea was to deter attackers with strict punishment, but the government back then did not pursue it. They said a separate law for doctors is unnecessary. But now that bill is back in focus and the IMA is pushing for it again. They say that a hospital should be as safe as an airport, and we must agree. Now, one law alone may not solve the entire problem, but at least it is a start. We can't just protest, politicize and procrastinate. We must be proactive. And like Rachna Govil ji today spoke on my Power Talk show, safety at the workplace must be non-negotiable. That's all for this episode of the Power Talk with me, Anukriti Sharma. I shall see you tomorrow again at 7 p.m. with yet another episode of the Power Talk. Till then, Jai Hind, Namaste. Keep watching CVR English.